Hello everyone, a warm welcome indeed to our Bannside gift service today. This is when we reach out to other girls and boys and their families to help them have a happy Christmas, filled with generosity and joy, sparkle and light. So, a big thank you to everyone who has given gifts this year. Thank you also to all of the girls and the boys taking part in the service today. From their own homes. It is a wonderful world that we live in just now. Last week, at the start of our journey through Advent this year, as we lit the first candle, we remembered that the light shines in the darkness, but the darkness has not overcome the light and will not be able to put it out. Today, as we focus on this second candle, we look forward to how people walking in darkness will see a great light because of Christmas. Through the birth of Jesus, a light will dawn on everybody living in the shadows and going through hard times. This Advent and always, we will walk in the light of the Lord. And we say, we believe that God provides light for all of our journeys. Alex Dean is now going to lead us in our Gift Sunday opening prayer, finishing with the Lord's Prayer. Then Alice, Amy, Ben, Luke and Ricky will bring us the first Noel. After that, pay really, really close attention to the journey of a gift. See how it all goes, where it ends up, and what we might learn from it. But first, we'll come to God in prayer.
Holy God, in this season of Advent, we travel towards Christmas. We give thanks that you are with us, and we are able to feel your love. In this season, when the days are short and darkness comes early, we give thanks that we can trust in your light to guide us to Bethlehem and the birth of the baby Jesus. In this season, when there is so much excitement, help us to be quiet and to enjoy all the signs of the wonder and magic of Christmas in the decorations and cards and lights. In this season of parcels and presents, help us to know that Jesus is the best gift of all, and that he wants us to share gifts with others so that they can have a good Christmas too. In this season of getting ready in our homes and in our hearts, may we find time to sing the song the angels sang, which says, "Peace on earth, goodwill to all." As we continue on our Advent journey to Bethlehem, to Christmas, to the humble shepherds, to the wise men, and the star guiding us to the stable where Jesus was born, hear us as we pray together, saying, "Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trials, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen."
Certain
See that? How did it happen? Wasn't it fantastic? Clara just threw a gift and a friend somewhere else caught it and passed it on. Then it got passed on and on and on again. Sometimes it even changed on the way. Amazing. Eventually, as you saw, it ended up with me. But it's not my No, it's not mine to hold on to, or open, or to enjoy. And you know, in a lovely way, what we have just done is remind ourselves that gifts are for sharing. God gives us gifts so that we can be generous, scattering them to people who really need them. That's what the Bible says. And when that sort of generosity happens, everybody is happy and will give thanks, those who get the gifts and those who give the gifts. The Bible says that too. And that's what we do on Gift Sunday. We spread the generosity, the happiness, and the thanksgiving. You know what? I think that's something to sing about. So the children are now going to bring us their song. It is entitled, What a Glorious Night. Then Zara and Robbie will bring us our reading. It is Luke chapter 2, verses 1 to 20. And it tells about the birth of Jesus, God's greatest gift to us all. After that, the children will bring us a super story called A Very Noisy Christmas. But let's start with that song. Thank you.
time, Augustus Caesar sent an order to all people in the countries that were under Roman rule. The order said that they must list their name in a register. This was the first registration taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. A registration counts all the people and all the things they own, and everyone went to their own towns to be registered. So Joseph left Nazareth, a town in Galilee. He went to the town of Bethlehem in Judea. This town was known as the town of David. Joseph went there because he was from the family of David. Joseph registered with Mary because he was engaged to marry him. Mary was now pregnant. While Joseph and Mary were in Bethlehem, the time came for her to have the baby. She gave birth to her first son. There were no rooms left in the inn, so she wrapped the baby with cloths and laid him in a box where animals were fed. That night, some shepherds were in the fields nearby watching their sheep. An angel of the Lord stood before them. The glory of the Lord was shining around them, and suddenly they became very frightened. The angel said to them, "Don't be afraid, because I am bringing you good news. It will be a joy to all the people. Today your Saviour was born in David's town. He is Christ the Lord. This is how you will know him. You'll find a baby wrapped in cloth and lying in a feeding box."
Then a very large group of angels from heaven joined the first angel. All the angels were praising God, saying, "Give glory to God in heaven, and on earth let there be peace and goodwill among people." Then the angels left the shepherds and went back to heaven. The shepherds said to each other, Let us go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened. We will see this thing the Lord told us about." So the shepherds went quickly and found Mary and Joseph. And the shepherds saw the baby lying in the feeding box. Then they told what the angels had said about this child. Everyone was amazed what they heard, what the shepherds said to them. Mary had these things in her heart. She continued to think about them. Then the shepherds went back to their sheep, praising God and thanking him for everything they had seen and heard. It was just that the angel had told them. May God help us to understand this reading and be faithful like the shepherds. Amen.
Very noisy Christmas!
It was a quiet, quiet night on the hillside.
The shepherds and the sheep were sleeping. Then suddenly,
an angel!
Shepherds were so scared. But wait, the angel was saying something.
Let's listen carefully. The angel said, "Don't be afraid. I bring you good news that will bring great joy to all people.
God's rescuer has been born in Bethlehem. He's the king of the whole wide, wonderful world.
You will find the baby wrapped snugly, lying in the manger." Then suddenly,
thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands of angels were praising God at the top of their voices.
The king has been born.
Glory to God.
Peace on earth.
Then suddenly,
the angels went back to heaven and everything was quiet again. The shepherds hurried off to Bethlehem.
They had found Jesus in a manger, just like the angel told them.
Shepherds wanted to tell everyone.
Wake up, everybody.
Amazing has happened. Jesus, the rescuer, has been born.
Meanwhile, in a land far, far away, some wise men were studying special books and watching the stars. Then suddenly,
wow, look, we're in it!
A new star had appeared in the sky. They knew the star meant a special king had been born.
So they packed their bags and went on a long, long, long journey to see the new king.
When they arrived, they found Jesus and gave him special gifts, gold and frankincense and myrrh.
They bowed down before him. They knew he was the king
of the whole wide, wonderful world.
Do you want to know something special? Jesus is God's son and our rescuer.
He is the king of the whole wide, wonderful world. Jesus came at the first Christmas so we can be friends with God forever.
Now that's something we're singing in giant butts.
Jesus is king.
Jesus is the king.
Joy to the world.
The first thing I want to do is to thank everyone who has taken part in our gift service today. So a huge thank you to all of the children for their singing and for their reading and leading us in prayer so wonderfully well. And a big thank you, too, to our musicians, to Alice, Amy, Ben, to Luke, and to Ricky. And also a big thank you to the behind-the-scenes folk, to Amy for coordinating with the kids and their mums and dads to get all of the parts done, and to Alice for video editing and production. Now, girls and boys, if you can, I want you to find the smallest pair of shoes that you have at home in your house. It would be fantastic if your mums and dads still had your baby shoes or your first walking shoes to show you. If not, find a picture of toddler-sized shoes or just imagine a pair. Now, think about those shoes. Next, take a look at your feet, the way they are today. Let me ask you this. Could you fit your feet into those incy-wincy tiny little shoes? No, you could not indeed. You could probably only fit in a toe or two. To get in your whole foot would simply be impossible. And you know, in some ways, that's kind of what Christmas is all about. But what is impossible for us, God is able to do. At Christmas, the God of the whole wide universe, the God who made stars and planets, rhinoceroses and giant whales, the God who is as strong can be, this God squeezed God's very self into a tiny little baby so that God could come to us and be like us and help us. What are we to make of this? Well, one of the ordinary shepherds from our reading today, those shepherds who were really there when Jesus had just been born, might have said something like this. Until tonight, I could not fit the size of God into my head. God was so big a thing to think about. I believed God was for prophets and kings and important people, people of words and people of wisdom, not for people like me. But tonight, because of the angels coming to us on the hillside and bringing us a special message and singing to us and sending us here to Bethlehem, I believe that I am looking at God. God made small. Small enough for me. Small enough to pick up and hold like a lamb. I could never talk to a big, powerful, far away God in the skies. A God up beyond the clouds. But tonight, when I look and smile and talk to this little baby, I somehow know that I am talking to God. And it is God who smiles back at me and waves his tiny hands in delight. And tonight, in your smallness, God, you are closer and more powerful and more real to me than you have ever, ever, ever been before. I can hold you now, hold you in my head, hold you in my arms, hold you in my heart. And I know that you are holding me too, in your head, in your arms, in your heart. And that is something to be noisy about and celebrate, and it is also something to be quiet about and to think about every day. Boys and girls, the truth about Christmas is that in Jesus, God comes to us so that we can know God and trust God and speak to God and use our feet, whatever size they are, to follow God as we follow in the footsteps of Jesus. Let us pray. Loving God of all the world, guide us by your light to Bethlehem again this year. Clear our hearts and our minds of everything that stops us knowing you and worshipping you more deeply in our own ways. Bring peace in our hearts, in our homes, in our world through Jesus Christ, the Prince of Peace. Be with the lonely, the sad, the sick, and the hungry at this time and always. Be with children who are worried and anxious and going through hard times. Help us to be like the shepherds, praising God and thanking God and playing our part, being kind and fair to everybody. In Jesus' name, amen. Now the hymn, Away in a Manger. Now, in anticipation, expectation, and rising excitement as we continue on our way to Christmas this strange year, which has been so very different. May we be filled with the wonder of the shepherds. May we be generous, just like the wise men. May we be kind, like Mary and Joseph. May we be guided by the starlight of God to Jesus, born in Bethlehem. And the peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the joy of the Holy Spirit be with us today, on our way, and always. Amen.